Rice is a staple food the Chinese people have depended on for thousands of years. As early as 10,000 years ago, the Shanshan ancient people in Jinhua, Zhenjiang province, began to cultivate rice artificially. After that, the story of rice never stopped. I'm Yulia from Russia. In my hometown, bread is a staple food on the table. It's different from China. With the opportunity to study in China, I went to Jinhua, the birthplace of rice. She is the hostess of this family. Also a hard-working female farmer. She showed me around the rice production process. The rice was ripe in the late October, and when I got there, only a small area had yet to be harvested. It's so like when I see the final harvest scene. Under the guidance of the hostess, I experienced the manual cutting of rice. The roots were tougher than I had imagined, and it was hard to imagine that they had to take care of such a big field by themselves. After the harvest, the rice was sent to be dried. Now they have huge drying rooms and a huge machine that can dry rice very quickly. Now the rice will not sprout again and will be preserved for a long time. They send the dried rice back home. There is a machine that grates out the husks, leaving only the rice which can be eaten. When it becomes like this, it's ready to eat. The Chinese call it cao mi, which is said to be better than the white rice.
Look, 大家都你咬一个都脱花了。 一个信用色好的那种，一个信用色一天都要上千多。
The hostess told me that this year's harvest was not good, but when I saw the mountains of rice, I couldn't understand what they meant by a bad harvest. I can't help imagining what a shocking sight it will be when the harvest is good.
好，
After begging, the host sends them to the dealers in the town. This is their daily work, and they have been doing it day after day for 12 years. At the same time, the old people in the family began to prepare dinner. There are five people in this family: grandparents, parents, and a child who is still in the kindergarten. These are other family members. They all depend on growing rice to survive. They also have an older daughter in college. Now the child have to prepare for school, which is a big expense for the family. Even though there are many machines to help them grow, they still live a hard life. They may be able to control the quality of rice and the operation of each machine, but they can't control the weather and the people in society. The way home for a grain of rice is always full of hardships.